in different ways, according to their charisms, according to their resources. But I think, as I've said, the first thing perhaps Catholics can do is to help me to spread the message of the new evangelization. I'm sure three-quarters of them do not even know what is the trust of the Church and the trust of the Universal Church. So I think the first thing our Catholics can do is try to spread the urgency of the new evangelization, renewal within the Church, and spreading the good news beyond the Church. That's the first thing. Then, secondly, I think the Catholics can do is to keep on encouraging each other to deepen their spiritual life. I mean, those are the foundations. The rest comes later. Without this, we cannot talk about the rest. The foundation. We need to renew their faith. They need to go for retreats. They need to find ways and means to renew their relationship with the Lord. After that, then we can talk about the rest. Because for me, I don't believe in telling people, our Catholics, to do things if they're not convinced. So, of course, at the end of the day, for all these programs to go on, we need money. There is no doubt. We need to build infrastructures. There is no doubt. But you see, our Catholics are certainly not giving enough. Although we are the biggest church in Singapore as a church, you know, our collection is very insignificant, our Sunday collections. And so that's why the officers, I cannot fulfill, we cannot build up our officers because they are short of funds. Our organizations are short of funds. They are short of places, buildings. So we need infrastructures. We need funds to pay for infrastructures, for operations. Presently, all the officers, they are having only a skeleton staff. How do we reach out to the whole world? How do we help the whole church when the office don't have the proper facilities and also the proper staff? So we need money for that. But that again, I don't want Catholics just to give for the sake of giving. They must know what they are doing. Because for those people, not all Catholics can be active in church because some of them have other responsibilities. Catholics also must not think that just because they're not active in church, they are maybe busy in their own profession as a doctor or lawyer or those who are in the public service. They're also doing church work. Anything that is done for the glory of God, for the service of God, that is also church work. You cannot distinguish between this is church work and that is non. Any work that is done for God is really godly work. It's a question of your motive. So there are some people who cannot be personally active in the church, but they are prayerful, they attend mass regularly, they read up about their faith, they have a faith community to share their faith, but they cannot be serving in the church like others. So some of these people, those who have funds, they can provide funds. But again, it's everybody must see that whatever we do, whether sharing our resources, whether giving out money, they are meant for the mission of the church. And every Catholic has a responsibility, has an obligation to help the mission of the church. So this is an obligation. You might not go out as a missionary, but if you have the funds and you have other responsibilities, then you should provide the funds accordingly. So give with a purpose. So I'm sure that if more Catholics are willing to give their time, their services, those who have no money can give time, can give resources. If we work together, we pull all this together, then of course we can build a church.